So kind of a BDSM situation with a little hellfire thrown in for some extra excitement. I'm Blake X, this is another nuclear reaction. What's up, survivors? So, it's another foggy day here in Chicago, and tomorrow I have off work, which is good because I'm gonna have a busy work-filled weekend. So, gonna enjoy my free time while I have it. And today I'm gonna be getting back to some black metal, doing another black metal reaction on this channel. And it coincides with the time in my life when I'm getting back into my occult studies and my personal rituals. I always say that I never have time for things. My personal occult work as a Satanist is part of that. Sometimes I just don't have time to get into it, but I've been exploring that more again, and getting back into the swing of things as far as that's concerned. So, I was just thinking along those lines, and I think it's a good time that I did another black metal reaction because I think the last one I did, what was the last one they did? Black Funeral, I think, was the last traditional black metal band that I reacted to on the channel. So today I'm going to be checking out this band that I've actually never heard before. They're called Devil Master, and the song I'm going to be listening to is Her Thirsty Whip. I basically went on Metal Archives and I just looked at a few bands. This band jumped out to me. The album artwork jumped out to me. I think it's really cool looking. And this song in particular jumped out to me because of the title. So I think that's a really interesting title. So, we're going to be checking that out today. This is a song that I picked, but there will be plenty more requests that will get reactions on this channel. I'm still going through the infinite list, so don't worry. I have lyrics pulled up as usual, and we are just going to jump right in. Hope everyone else is having a good day or a good night, depending on when you see this. And I have my wine here. I'm feeling pretty relaxed right now. So I'm looking forward to hearing how this sounds. It's been a while since I've heard a new black metal band, because I've heard so much black metal that it's hard for me to find a band that I haven't heard before. But we're gonna see how these guys are. So yeah, if you like this content, please subscribe to my channel. Give this video a thumbs up if you like it, thumbs down if you don't. If you want notifications, click the bell beneath the video. Link to the original video will be in the description. Also in the description will be a link to the official Nuclear Reactions merch store, Yield Nuclear Shop, as well as a link to the official Nuclear Reactions Facebook group, the Mushroom Cloud. So check out both of those things if you're interested. All right. Her Thirsty Whip. Devil Master. All right. I love that album artwork. That's really cool. Let's do it in 3, 2, 1, go. This is not black metal. Okay, maybe it is. So I'm guessing this is like a little bit of melodic black metal, obviously melodic, mixed with a little like groove element. I'm not quite sure what other subgenre this is mixed with, but it's definitely not pure black metal. I don't think it's even pure melodic black metal. But nevertheless, I think it's really good so far. I wasn't expecting it to have such a fast pace, and wasn't expecting the guitar to sound the way that it did. But I like it so far. It's got a lot of energy. It's got a lot of aggression. I like the vocals. They have that, growl, roaring kind of effect that I really like. There's a lot of ferocity in the harsh vocals there, so that's really good. So, no complaints so far, man. I'm digging it. So, let's continue. Oh, there. There it is. So I don't care whether this is considered true cult or not. I'm really, really digging this fucking song so far. This is fantastic so far as I'm concerned. You have like parts that are very black metal-ish to me, mixed with parts that are like very, very melodic, and then there's like an underlying groove that carries through the whole thing. That's basically what I'm hearing. So, you know, you may know better than me because, you know, again, instrumentation is not my thing. I mainly focus on the lyrics. I don't know necessarily about what goes into the music. I just know whether or not I like it. So, you know, if you know more, if you know better, feel free to correct me in the comments below. But all I know is that my ears are really digging it so far. And this is some good shit, man. What can I say? Let's finish it up. There's so much going on here. Holy shit. That was her Thirsty Whip by Devilmaster. I think I just happened upon a hidden gem here, a demon in the rough, if you will. Ah, man, such lame humor. No, I really like this one, man. I especially toward the end there was, like I said, so much going on. Like I heard, obviously a synth element toward the end, which I was not expecting at all. That came out of nowhere, and then combined with that, there was like a very folky sound there at the end, and then on top of that, you had the black metal and like the groove sound in there. And it was just so many different styles coming together in a way that I don't usually hear, and in a way that I definitely was not expecting. It's crazy, man. I I gotta fucking hear more about this band. That's they are getting a revisit on this channel, and they're getting one soon. And especially if you guys like this, so let me know what you think of this song in the comments, and how you feel about it. All I know is that I'm really digging what I heard. And, you know, I always like it when black metal gets a little bit of experimentation going on in it, and it gets a little bit of a, you know, a burst of freshness in it, without venturing too far outside of the, you know, black metal parameters. You know, if a band wants to branch out and take elements of black metal and do something totally different with them, you know, and contribute to a new genre or a different genre, I think that's fine. So I'm not against like all the so-called atmospheric black metal bands like Agalloch and Panopticon and Wolves in the Throne Room and all that stuff. I know the true cult elitists often don't like those bands, but I'm not against them. I just don't consider them to be pure straight-up black metal. On the other hand, when you have bands like, you know, like Watain or Thantafaxith, which are doing something different with the genre but are still doing a very black metal thing, that's a different thing altogether. Now, I think these guys fall somewhere in the middle based on the song. I feel that they're not too far outside the realm of black metal in the way that, you know, some of these, you know, Pacific Northwest atmospheric quote unquote black metal bands are. But I also feel that they're definitely not a pure strain of traditional or orthodox black metal in the way that, you know, Watain is or Nightbringer or a band like that. So they're very much like in the middle. So I'm very intrigued by this band, man. I'm intrigued by them musically. I really like the album artwork, which is what attracted me to, partly what attracted me to this band in the first place as I was looking through metal archives. So good shit all across the board so far, man. Of course, I didn't get to the lyrics yet, which I'm going to do now. By the way, this album is called Satan Spits on Children of Light, which I also really like that name. And this just came out this year, so I think this is the first full-length by these guys. I think they're a pretty new band. So Devil Master is absolutely on my radar. That's all I can say. Let's check out the lyrics here. Cross my mind with demonic fear. Cross my dreams with faults. Crush my dreams with for my cries. Can't read tonight, apparently. Torn shadows flagellate me and follow me out of the dream. Controlling the night. Skin and bone falling out. I fear not because I've dreamed of her. Dreamed of such endless pain. Ecstasy came tonight. It tore through myself with a glowing might. It screamed forth, lashed me as I die. Burning to rubble, ash and dust. Burning right through my soul. Screaming as they die. Interesting. A little bit of pleasure and pain, huh? Because it says, I've dreamed of such endless pain, and then it says, ecstasy came tonight. So here, dying and being tormented is a good thing. So the idea behind this song seems very similar to Hellraiser, right? With basically the blending of pleasure and pain, or the blurring of that line that separates the two, you know. I guess you could call it masochism, but I've also heard it defined as divine suffering, which I find to be a very interesting concept, or a very interesting name for it. And I think there are a number of things that cause people to, you know, derive a good or pleasurable feeling from pain, but two that jump out to me are desensitization and control. Now, I want to address the second one first, because it made me think of just now of my teen years, because when I was like 14, 15, 16, more like 16, 17 actually, there was this trend, and sometimes it wasn't a trend, sometimes it was a case of someone being suicidal, but more often I saw it being a trend, especially in the high schools and everything like that, where people would basically cut themselves and show it off to everybody, you know, or, you know, pretend to cover it up and humble brag about it. At least, you know, that was something that a lot of people my age at the time were doing in New Jersey. And now, you know, you can get into how that's an insult to the people who are cutting for emotional or suicidal reasons. You can make that argument for sure. And that's worth discussing. But that's a whole separate discussion, though, as important as it may be, or as significant as it may be. And not quite where I'm going with this. So I'm not going to touch upon that so much today in this video. What I'm trying to get at is the fact that a lot of the people who would engage in cutting and other forms of self-harm, they sometimes had tough lives and, you know, they got bullied and attacked, so on and so forth. Not enough, I think, to make them really, like, suicidal, because, like, I heard some of those very same people admit that they were not feeling that way. It was not necessarily because of depression or anything like that. So for those people in particular, I think that a big part of it was them trying to create for themselves a feeling of security or self-control on a personal level. And I'm talking again about, you know, the people who cut themselves without the intention of committing suicide. You know, I'm not trying to discredit the people who are deeply depressed and, you know, as just doing it for attention or anything like that. I'm not trying to do that at all. And I know this is a very touchy subject for a lot of people, so I'm not trying to, you know, upset anyone here at all. And depression and suicide are real things, and it's real shit, and people that I go through that have my utmost sympathy. But I'm talking about people who did it just to do it. And so psychologically, by inflicting pain upon themselves, they were gaining a sense of, or at least the belief that they were having mastery over some aspect of their own lives, where previously they felt that they had no control. At least that's my theory on that. I'm not a psychologist by any means. It's just my, you know, my best guesstimate, you know. And I don't know if it's totally correct. That's just what I think, you know. And then the other reason, desensitization. I feel like people who basically experience a sensory overload of something in their lives, whether it's sex or pain or violence, they eventually get to a point where they need to keep pushing themselves further and further. So, for example, someone gets so sexually desensitized that they have to keep pushing into newer and newer territory. Eventually go into the most complete extreme, you know. And I've seen it, and I've heard about that happening. That's all I'm going to say on that one. Same thing with pain. You know, if someone has endured or even seen a lot of it, pain or violence, they may or may not try and integrate that into their lives by choice and make it something that they interpret as pleasurable. Actually, that reminds me of the Tool song. What was the name of it again? It dealt with this exact subject. Stinkfist. It was called Stinkfist. and if you're a Tool fan, you should check out that song. It was a good one. But he made a good point, similar to the one that I'm making here in that song. So this is kind of an intriguing topic, lyrically speaking, because it provides a window into some not often explored psychology, you know. Although with this song in particular, and this, of course, being black metal, I feel that there is a dark spiritual element here, and I'm definitely going to get into that. So, if you look at some of the more choice lines here, like, cross my mind with demonic fear, torn shadows flagellate me, I dreamed of her, dreamed of such endless pain, ecstasy came to the night, it tore through myself. So kind of a BDSM situation with a little hellfire thrown in for some extra excitement. In all seriousness, it sounds like this is about someone who is being visited by a succubus, or possibly succubi, meaning more than one. Now, a succubus for the uninitiated, and for those who just aren't willing to get that kinky, is a feminine demonic spirit that has sex with people in their sleep. Now, the effect that that has on the person varies by lore and by religious denomination. For Satanists, it's said that this has a strengthening effect, although as far as I know, I've never encountered a succubus, so I can't speak from personal experience. for those who fear demons, it's said that the succubus drains that person's energy and causes their psyche to deteriorate, basically. And I'm inclined to believe that, you know, based on what I know and what I've experienced when working, just in a general sense, with what I refer to as dark intelligences. So, what's interesting is that while a lot of average lay people might not know what a succubus is, they were so well known and feared, and even loved by some people, centuries ago, that there are actually tons of statues and carvings of them that we can still go and see all around the world today. A lot of people don't know that, you know. There's a big statue of a screaming succubus in Mexico City, I believe. Yeah. And then there's a sculpture of a succubus in Cambridge. I believe there's one somewhere in Eastern Europe as well, but I'm not sure exactly where. But yeah, the general belief in them used to be quite strong in some parts of the world. And just like demons themselves, almost every culture that I know of had some version of the succubus that they believed in. Now, some Christians believe that the succubi were descended from Lilith, who was usually depicted as a female demon, and who in biblical apocrypha was Adam's first wife. Of course, I personally consider Lilith to be an alternate name for Lilitu, mentioned in Sumerian lore. But that's getting off topic and too much to get into right now. That's just me geeking out about history and occult lore and all that stuff, but too much to discuss at the moment, but so I think this is very much about someone who feels a kind of, you know, twisted spiritual connection with the succubus and basically longs for a suffering that has kind of become desirable to him, which, you know, really calls into question, in my opinion, the Christian view of hell. Because the idea there is that people suffer for eternity, but it's like what happens when you get a sadomasochist who actually enjoys the suffering. And that's what I found so interesting about Hellraiser, which is actually one of my favorite horror films. Because you basically have a place full of this sickness and torture and, you know, perversity. But you have people who, some might say, you know, degenerated to such a degree that they love it, you know, and so you're left with this apparent paradox, because you have this place where people are in a state of perdition and torment, but for them it's become paradise. I always found that to be a very interesting concept and idea. That's part of the reason why I like that movie so much. Highly recommend seeing Hellraiser if you haven't. Classic horror movie, completely underrated. Everybody talks about Nightmare on Elm Street and Friday the 13th, and everyone always skips over Hellraiser. I don't know why. It's a really good movie, man. I really like the Cenobite that had the chattering teeth, and I love that scene, the Jesus wept scene, which, if you don't know what it is, I'm not going to spoil it. Just go watch it for yourself. And I really, the song doesn't mention it, but the title of the song, I really like the title, Our Thirsty Whip. So basically this whip that craves blood, like in The Walking Dead, when Negan used his bat, Lucille, and he was bashing poor Glenn's head in, and, he made the joke that Lucille was a vampire bat, which, you know, as dad jokes go, I thought it was pretty clever. So yeah, you know, A Whip That Thirsts for Blood, that's a cool title for sure. Makes me think of a demoness, you know, wielding a cat of nine tails, you know. And that also makes me think of an actual goetic, or goetic, however you choose to pronounce it, demon named Elagos, sometimes called Abigor. And what was said about the visage that Elagos comes in, or presents himself in, is that he carries a whip made out of a human spine. Ouch. There's a cool old, like, 16th or 17th century drawing of that somewhere, actually. If you could find it online, check it out. It's pretty interesting looking. I even considered getting a tattoo of it at one point. But yeah. Everything about this song just jumped out to me and stuck out to me as being really cool. I really dug this one, man. What can I say? This has been another good week for reactions, because I've heard so much good shit. I almost wish that I would get a song that I really dislike, you know, because right now I think it seems like so unbalanced, because I'm giving all these high ratings to all these songs that I'm reviewing, and, you know, I don't want to seem like one of those channels that never gives an honest, fair rating, because I always try and do that. It's just that, like, between you guys recommending me so much good shit on the Infinite List, and between my own luck with my own picks all turning out to be really good so far, like, everything has just been up there for me, man. Over the past few days, at least. So, I don't know. Good stuff. I don't think I have anything to criticize about the music at all. I really liked it. I'm not even going to pick out those little experimental elements at the end, like the little folk influence and a little synth influence, because that intrigued me even more. Like, I want to hear whether or not more of their songs have any of that sound in them. You know, whether they do more with that. And I want to hear how else they're experimenting and what other influences they bring into their songs. So, I definitely want to hear more from this band, and specifically off this album. Although I think this is their only album that they've come out with so far. But I didn't research them all that much on Metal Archives. I just looked at this one album and picked out a track to check out. So, maybe I'll have to research them a bit more. But, let me know if you guys have heard Devil Master before. What you think of them. If you want to see me do another reaction, I'm probably going to do it anyway. I'm going to give this one... This shit is solid, man. I dug it. I'm going to give this one a 12 out of 12 in the Doomsday Clock. It's not even up for debate with me, man. I just really like this one. So... Alright, there you have it. Her Thirsty Whip by Devil Master. You guys have shown me a lot of support over the past couple of months, so I just want to say thank you again. And, the channel's come a long way. I mean, this only started in early March, man. You know, it's what, almost July now? A couple weeks? So, time flies, but, you know, at the same time, it hasn't been all that much time since this channel first came into being, so, or since I first started doing reactions, so. considering the time span, a lot has happened since then, you know? So a lot of that is owed to you guys. So once again, I really appreciate it. And thank you for subscribing. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do. Also, let me know some genres that you want me to explore more on this channel. I know Camp Deathcore wants more deathcore all the time. I know that I've been diving into thrash and speed metal a lot. Well, not a lot, but a little bit. I like black metal, and there's some other people who have made black metal requests. Let me know if there's any other genres, though, that you want to see more of, that you want to see more reactions to. I'm here to talk with you guys and to communicate with you guys, so don't be shy. Alright, that was Devil Master, and that is it for this video. So, hope you guys are doing well, and I will catch you all next time.